Hey guys, welcome to this play Trails in the Sky, Secret Time to Blind. I did a career play, yay! We're back now. Oh, look at the clouds moving on the... aren't the clouds moving kind of the wrong way? It looks like we're moving sideways. Hey, the clouds stopped when I opened the menu. So we're back here. And now we'll go talk to Olivier. Out we go. So I have to put on my other headphone. That's beautiful. You're beautiful. I talked to these guys first. I wish I could have spent more time in the hot springs. Magazine reporters don't get any breaks. Speedy reporting is our lifeblood. And you can bet I'll have my latest report written up the instant we hit the dock. That's dedication. Oh. Ah, still, my fair rose. Don't stop playing. Welcome to Olivia Lenehan's... Olivier Lenehan's lovely solo recital. Oh, adios, he escaped his chair. Chloe, remember you have a sword and you know how to use it. Well, I saw him playing when I stepped out onto the deck, so I came by to listen for a little while. He really is exceptionally talented. Your compliments do me the greatest honor, Your Highness. If you wish, when we arrive at the capital, I could treat you to a private concert. Oh God, his face! Olivier! Scree? Sieg, yes. That did not necessarily mean anything beyond the obvious. You meant something else by private concert, Olivier? Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt this wonderful scene. I thought I heard a cat and being mischievous, but they were just using the little box, so never mind. Is she pretending that she doesn't understand? Because... Well, if you wish for it to mean something more, my princess, it certainly could. Scree! Oh, God, I clipped. Sorry about that. Oh, wah! Bird! Please, stop, Sieg! I'm sorry. I won't do it again. Good job, Sieg. You're a girl's best friend. Aww. Huh. That was terrifying. I'm sorry, Olivier. That was just Sieg expressing his love. I actually think he likes you, on the whole, Olivier. Scree! I love the bird! Oh, you're so cute. I shall bear his peck on my cheek with pride, then. I must admit, I did not expect your escort to be so diligent. There's a snowplow outside at the moment. He is as vigilant as any of the human royal guards. Depends on who I'm dealing with, I think. You really are totally indiscriminate, aren't you, Olivier? Oh, God. Can you please... Olivier, please. No. Although, I feel like with Olivier, it's not sexual. It's just... that's what I like to think anyway. But it's like... He's just so enamored by beautiful things that it's not sexual, I don't think. Especially because he... Like, with him and Dita, like, I think it's, like, a very pure kind of... Not that sex isn't pure, but you know what I mean. Like, I think... Anyway, sorry. Look, don't try to put the moves on Chloe in the capital, okay? Julie would, like, fire you out of a cannon into the sun, if you even think about it.
Ah, yes, that cold, dignified lady officer. She, too, caught my eye during the coup. The sort of woman who can take on 10 men. She's quite something. Should the chance present itself, I should endear myself to her.
What's wrong, Chloe?
It might not be such a good idea to joke about such things around Julia, Olivier. I remember once there was a party at the castle and a man was drunk and bothering us. Julia, took her sword and his clothes, well...
What?
You mean she, defrocked him? Her face. I didn't think that's where that was gonna go. I thought she was gonna say that, like, something terrible happened to Julia at one point or something. I did. Okay. Whew. Okay, that scared me just a little bit.
I'll take that under consideration.
Yeah, you're playing again.
I would presume nothing less terrifying from the Lady Knight who defies the Royal Guard. But know this, the flames from which my passion first was kindled shall ne'er fade. Even if I must be stripped naked before her, I shall serenade her with naught but my lute in hand.
I so did not need that mental image.
Thanks, Olivier. Good point. Oh god, my brain.
God, oh man, I forgot how good this game was. Oh god.
You know, the Liberal News wrote an article about that party. Julia gained a lot of, admirers, from high security to the poorest commoner. I've always felt a little sorry for the man involved, though.
Seriously? Don't you think he got what he deserved? Interesting.
Thank you for flying with us today. We will be arriving in Grandsire shortly. Please be aware that there may be turbulence while landing, so we ask that all passengers take their seats. So we ask that all passengers take their seats. Take their seats.
I don't know, I can't talk like an aerostat. And here we are back in the capital again. Feels pretty good. Guess we better check in with the guild branch first, huh? Let's go hear from Elnan what's what.
I did notice that a certain white ship isn't in port today. The Arsail, I believe it was.
Huh? You're right. That's the royal family's personal cruiser, right? Might be out on a mission or something.
If I recall, the Arsail should be at least in fortress at the moment.
Yeah. It's being fritted. It's been fitted with the new engine Professor Russell and his colleagues have been working on.
Oh yeah, Gustav said he'd be flying out to Layson on the factory's airship.
Oh, I see. So that awesome ship has been made even more awesome? I seriously can't wait to see that. They're just changing the engine, so I doubt the exterior will change much. But it'll totally be the world's fastest airship, that's for sure. Welcome everyone, and thank you for coming. I've read the reports on Rowan and Zeiss. Good work, truly. You've done well in opposing the society thus far.
I doubt the guys we've fought would agree.
Both that masked man and the guy with sunglasses didn't really seem to take it or us seriously. Even knowing that the society is moving as valuable as hell, don't disparage yourself. Your successes should make the Royal Army trust us even further. So, speaking of which, what does the army want with us? Something society related? Yes, about that. It seems they don't want to discuss it over the phone. An army official will be coming by soon to explain the situation in person.
Something that cannot be discussed by phone, they say. What they mean is that they do not wish to risk any unwelcome ears listening in on the call.
Wait, you can do that? Oh yes, it's quite possible. Telephones are convenient, but with the right equipment, intercepting conversation signals are very difficult. We use a scrambling device between branches to prevent interception of guild business. Unfortunately, the scrambling doesn't work with the army for some reason? Yes, the army uses a different system. All calls between us thus completely open. Well, that's ducky. Ducky? Is this supposed to say sucky?
Why does it say ducky? Didn't this happen in first chapter as well?
Sorry, I just had to blow my nose. But yeah, didn't this happen in first chapter as well? I feel like there was something. Maybe it was Xenogaze or something. Well, that's ducky. Why can't the army just share a mixer scrambler thingamajigger with us? We are working together, but we're still an international citizens group and they're a national defense force. As much as your father trusts us, Estelle, I don't think they can give us something so sensitive so easily. Hang on, Alnon. It still sounds like you've got some idea of what this is all about. Otherwise, you wouldn't have bothered calling us out as ice. Am I being that transparent? I can only hazard a guess, really, but I believe it's very likely this has to do with the signing of the Non-Aggression Pact. The Non-Aggression Pact? I remember hearing something about that. What exactly is going on with that, anyway? It is a treaty affecting Liberal, Erebonia, and Calvid, proposed by Grandmother. In short, it says all countries involved will attempt at all times to solve international disputes without resorting to force. Whoa. So, like, it'll end war? Well, no. There's no true enforcement mechanism beyond simply being known as a treaty breaker, so enforcing it like that would be difficult. It should still be something of a deterrent, though, and it will hopefully promote more friendly relations between ourselves and others. Okay, I get it. Queen Alicia does it again. She's got a good eye for this kind of thing. It'd have been neat if that made the countries nicer to each other. The pact is being signed in a large ceremony at the Oberall Villa next weekend. Dignitaries from all three nations will be attending and the media is paying close attention. Which is to say, they may as well have painted a sign on the roof of the villa saying, Autobots, please attack us. Oh, yeah, that could get really ugly. Got our work cut out for us then. Guess we just wait here for the army official for now? Correct. We do have some time before he's scheduled to arrive, so feel free to... Oh, pardon me a moment. Hello, this is the Grand Seal Bracer Guild Branch. Yes. Yes. I see. Yes. That certainly is a problem. Just a moment, please. Is that the army on the phone? No, it's a member of the Oberall Villa staff. They seem to have a lost child from one of the tourists in their care. Unfortunately, they can't seem to actually locate her parents. I wonder if it's that person from that place. Yeah, because they say tourist. Yeah, it's probably her. That's awful. Those people from, I think they're from Erebonia or something. Do they want us to help? Just so, Your Highness. They've asked for our aid in locating the child's parents or guardians. Can my hair please get out of my face? I like just washed it so it's like, ah, I'm hair! It's really annoying. There's still some time before our guests... There's still some time before our guest from the army is due to arrive. Oh, our guest from the army is due to arrive. Would you mind taking care of this? Sure, we'd be glad to. You're in, right, Agate? Can't say no to a kid in need. Let's head out. Aw, that's cute. Thank you. Hello? Yes, we have a team of bracers we can dispatch immediately. Look how happy he is. And your name, sir? Yes, understood. Well then, our bracers will be over as soon as they are able. The lost child is in the charge of a butler named Raymond. Once we arrive at the villa, inquire with him. Alright then, Raymond sounds familiar. Yeah! Wait a sec, Raymond. Why does that ring a bell? What? Wasn't he that one butler we found? You know, when we saved Chloe during the coup? He was hiding under a counter. Right, Neil's friend. Ah, good. If you know him, that should make things even easier. Well then, good luck. Please form your party. I will take the same. Oh, your aid.
Your aid, please.
Wait.
Oh, okay.
Sure. I mean, they didn't have to be in that order, but whatever.
skill time. Entertain a group monster. Carnicider. Monster possesses extremely thick skin and has dizzying attacks. Respond equipped with hearts. Okay. Oh no, do we have to go back into the sewer? Please, no, why? grants us a monster. Wait, I still have my old, do I have my old map? Oh no, wait, didn't it come with a map? Or did it? Oh, I don't remember. Anyway, a dangerous monster, Mad Tree, has been seen in the Grand South Sewers. Enter the West Block entrance. Specializes in blood-sucking attacks. Reports suggest it may be weak to fire arts. Well, I guess now we go around here and talk to all the people. This is gonna take 5 million years. But oh well. Hey, how's it going? I'll be here if you need me. I probably should have Chloe in the party. I should have Chloe in the party. Hold on. Because, I mean, it's her home, so. Let me just write down what Tita has on so I can put it back on her later. Moi Haru, can you get on my face? Do you have to sit on the paper? Is that necessary? What are you doing? Can I please continue writing on this piece of paper? Is it yours now? Is it? Are you okay there? What are you doing? Why are you being so annoying today? Huh? You're being so annoying today. Can you move, please? Do you mind? Is this necessary? Do you have to sit right there? Do you? Do you? Is it the thing that you do? Is it? Okay, I'm gonna go take a photo so you can see what is happening right now. Ooh, she has blue ascension. Holy shit, water 12. Blast an enemy with an explosive fountain of water. I don't think we had that in the first chapter. Ooh, that's exciting. Although she doesn't have... she doesn't have diamond dust. Why is that? What do you need for diamond dust? How do I open the book? Is it this book? Magic, right? Oops. Diamond dust needs 2 green, 1 space. Does she not have that? Oh, she has 1 green. I think she has space. Yeah, she has space. Well, maybe I can buy some. Oh, there we go. There you go. Now, does she have it? Yay! Alright, so I've sorted- oh no, I haven't, that's a lie, sorry. Ooh, yeah, now he can have the- I keep thinking it's just a long beard. Okay, so now I've sorted everything. He has that on. Chloe has this stuff on. I pretty much just put on the augments that she had before. I mean, the court she had before, except I put the yin-yang on her. Septian Vein goes on her. Estelle then got Heaven's Eye instead, and Olivier went back to his non-healer stuff. Yeah, that's pretty much it.
Ooh, he can do Hellgate. Yeah, which he could do before, but whatever. Yeah, so that's how it is. Let's go. I love you, Tita, but I think it makes sense for Chloe to be in the party at the moment. Plus, we haven't had her in the party in a while. So, I guess I'll go to one end of the town and talk to everybody. Oh god, this is going to take a million years. Okay. Troy's late again. I want to get out to the harbor and play. Oops. The likelihood Troy will be late for our agreed time is 83%. He's always 83. He's always getting sidetracked by something. Not like it's going to be any different today. I see. This is the center of Lubil, the royal capital, Grandcell. We might have had a coup d'etat not too long ago, but it's all back to normal now. Norman's crepe. Oh, and Nonna's crepe. I thought I said Norman. Norman's crepe stand. Sweet crepe. Yes. A saturine desert brimming with cream. What does saturine mean? Every episode, I have to get out the dictionary. Saturine. I should take a photo of this dictionary. It's really humongous. Really humongous. Not just humongous, but really humongous. Saturine. Oh, sorry, I'm saying it wrong. It's saccharine. Really? Saccharine. Excessively sweet, sugary, saccharine smell of the nature of or containing sugar. Or saccharine, I guess. Saccharine. 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 Apparently? Saccharine. Okay, what's a new word? Low calorie despite the contents. Truly a mystery. Oh, it cures confuse. $20. Thank you very much. Oh, right, I can turn the camera, of course. Of course. Hey, welcome to the capital. Why not have some popcorn while you're taking a break? Okay. Mobility popcorn. A popular snack so airy you'll feel lighter if you eat it. Okay. If you want to go to the Royal Villa, it's right out that gate there and south along the Royal Avenue. When you hit the fork in the road at the guidepost, next head towards the Gruner Gate. Then once you hit the next fork, head south and you should reach the Royal Villa. You shouldn't get lost as long as you make sure to read the guidepost carefully and look at your map, I guess. The south block here is the Brewer's Guild and lots of shops. The north block is the kingdom's largest hotel, and further north of that is Grandcell Castle. The west block's known for the Lubil News and the cathedral, and the east block's got embassies from neighboring countries, the Grand Arena, and a department store. Right, I've forgotten an important point. On the other side of the west block, there's a port and a warehouse district. It was closed off during the coup d'etat. No one could get in. Oh, Jesus. I remember. Where the things are. Believe it or not, I remember. Let me just talk to everyone that's outside first. Did I talk to you? Yes, I did. No, I didn't talk to you then. Apparently, the pianist who was frequenting that bar there until recently played some amazing performances. He was a strange one, but I think his skills at least were the real deal. He's like right there, but okay, that's hilarious. Hello, lovely weather we're having. When the weather's this nice, you can't help but feel nice too. The factory in this town is a very nice repairman. Okay. Oh, these people like walking in a circle. Okay. Oh, I'm so hungry, I feel like I could die. Alright, let's have something to eat, shall we? Smells so good. Huh? I feel like I said I'd do something. What was it? Oh, that's Troy. That's hilarious. If I talk to these kids now. No? Okay. I'm just like gonna be a dick and not tell them where he is. It's like, Kids these days. I don't know. Oops. I've now talked to you three times. Okay, now that we've talked to everybody in this little section, let me go back. All the way down here. Now we will go inside the buildings. Doesn't matter how busy he is, Tom will never refuse a request. Even though we'd make a lot more selling a new product than doing some stupid repairs. I wish Tom would start thinking about profits first. Yes, quartz. Oh, you have level 3. Oh, they're expensive though. Oh my goodness. Strike. Ooh, I want all of the things. All of them. I don't know what to take. I want them all. Sorry. Okay, let's take one of these. One of these. Actually, let's take this instead. Because it's good because it increases your arts ability. I mean, HP is good as well, of course, but still. I can't afford to hit. Sadly. Take this. Oh, I have seal? Did I know this? Does anyone have this on? Oh, we don't have shield 2 yet. Do I want shield 2 when I can have shield 3? I don't know if I do. Actually, it rhymed. I don't know which one to take. So I'll take shield 3 for now. This. Oh, I was hoping for a cast 3. Oh no, I should have bought another one of these. Oh, move 2! Yeah, I did want to move 2. Okay. Can't really afford anything else. I am going to put on not that on a gate. He can have move 2. Napalm breath. Ooh. Crimson flames that erupt from below. Oh, really? Oops. Actually, have I looked at all of this? Garden of Sedan. That's new, isn't it? Premium herb tea. Ooh, that looks cool. Sea bubbles. Rare fish egg dish with an irresistible popping texture. I see. Salt roasted fish. A small fish cooked to moist perfection in a crust of salt. Foul magma roast. Crispy outside, juicy inside. The spice crust is perfection. The sandwiches look so boring now. It's funny. Oh, is that what the sandwich looks like? I thought it looked more like this. Tomatrio sandwich. Stuffed with 3 slices of vegetable, tomato, the epitome of bitter. That's cool. Anyway, I guess I have to replace all these now. Oh no, I won't give that to her. I'll give it to him. Never mind, he already has one. Alright, I'll give it to her then. Tech 3, there you go.
I don't think anyone has defense stuff. Oh, he has this. He probably can't put on strike then. Am I right? Yeah, that sucks. Did I get an evade? No, I got a shield. Oh, shield. Here you go. I got a mind 3, so you can have that. Which means he can have mind 2. What else did I get? I have action 3. What else? I don't think there was anything else. Except for the defense stuff. Okay! No, wait, nope, I wasn't done yet. Wait, what about here? Okay, anything on this floor? No books for me to steal? Hey, welcome, this is the repairs desk. If you've got a broken augment, I can fix it for you here. Can our augments not break, please? Because, yeah, that would suck. Alright. Finally leave the shop, shall we? Next is this. Yeah, alright. Oh, you're the team of braces that won the martial arts competition. Welcome, welcome indeed. Thank you. What a nice welcome. Oh, that's better than the thing that I found? That's so sad. That's so sad! Fine. Salamander. I won't bother with the other things for now. I'll get that later. Ooh, I guess he's coming back to the party. God, that's so annoying. Stupid weapon shop that just keeps spoiling who's coming. Although, I didn't know that Zane was going to show up. So that was nice. Still. Jesus. I swear to God, if we come to a weapon store and there's like, there are some daggers, I'm like going to throw something against the wall. They wouldn't do that though, right? That would be... Surely. Maybe I should stop going into weapon stores. Anyway, I was just trying to not look so hard. I do not know what I want. Fiber boots. There's so many up and down things. I don't know what I want. Strega F. Goodness. Looks like Chloe might want those. I was hoping there would be... Oh, no, never mind. The cat stuff would be with the other place, not here. One of these. Okay, alright. Oh my god. The birthday celebration's over and the town's regained its calm. This quiet sure is nice. Yeah, actually, that's a good point. There are like a lot less NPCs to talk to than there were before, I think. At least it feels that way. Wait, I wasn't done. Okay, now I'm done. My wife can't stop thinking about the martial arts competition. I don't mind her thinking about the martial arts competition next year, sure, but on the other hand, she could help out with a few of the chores while she's thinking about it. Okay. I can't wait until next year. I can't wait for the next martial arts competition. General goods store. Maybe it's in a different part of town. Fish. Oh, hey! Hey! The Fisherman's Guild! This makes sense now! Because back in first chapter it was like, what the hell is the point of the Fisherman's Guild? But it makes sense now! Aww, that's cool. Welcome to the Fisherman's Guild! I am Fisher, the Baron of Fishing, as they. The Baron of Fishing, as they call me. Are you new applicants? If you like fishing, you're more than welcome. Oh, is that it? Okay. Da 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 da. Can I have all of these? No. Oh, hey, you guys. Lloyd, so you're back from Rouen, huh? How's the fishing been? Getting some of that, some use out of that rod I gave you? Kinda. I go in between work when I can. Good folk like you are always welcome at the Fisherman's Guild. If you ever want to join, talk to our headman Fisher at any time. I'm sure he'll be overjoyed to have a new comrade. I'll consider it. Even though he won't like me, but okay. The master fish that hide all over in each region. I'd like to be able to fish up one someday. It would be nice, wouldn't it? Okay, so there's still no point to the Fisherman's Guild. That's great. Just checking. You never know, things might have changed. Hop. Maybe it's because the signing ceremony is closed. Lately I see a lot of foreigners in the store. Sunnybell in Mocking Pie. A machine-made pie so delicate that it looks handmade. Oh, I have this already. During the coup d'etat, a lot of officials and servants got kicked out of the castle. Now those people are all busy back at work. Cleaning up after such an event's hard, though, so things won't go back to normal right away. Oh. How did I miss doing this? Yay. Seafood hot pot. Let's have a look at it. Ooh, it looks so good. I have a pot that looks just like that, actually. Well, it's a bit higher, but it's a similar kind of thing. I need a general goods store, please. Where is it? Let's go to this side first, because I have a feeling something's gonna happen on the side that has all the embassies. Just a feeling. So I'll go there last, I think.